Okay, 好, now I will share my screen, then you can see all the content. 你们知道这个 on the poster, 这个你们看过吗?
The scholar buys a donkey, what does that mean?
Yeah, so 博士, so the first two characters are 博士, 买驴, buy the donkey. To be honest, yeah, to be honest, as a Chinese, it's the first time I saw the idioms. Yeah, 但是 yup, 知道这个是什么意思。So yup, could you please help us to know more about the idioms? And also, it's our first idioms today.
I was making the poster and for some reason I wanted the donkey, so I used this idiom. Scholar buying a donkey, somebody who's making a very long point and doesn't get to the point actually, like a very long talking.
Today, our Chinese are very like beginner, intermediate, advanced level, 我们都有。So I'm also very glad that all the idioms I prepare, I think it will be very useful in our daily life. Not like 博士买驴, even Chinese people don't know that. And so 成, 成 is to become, it's and also already set. And 语, 我们学汉语。说英语，说西班牙语，说很多很多不同的语，所以 language. So 成语 of course, it's not very flexible. It won't changeable a lot. So it will be set. 所以成语 is have very long history and also very long development already. And all the 成语 is have a very typical explanation stories behind that. And usually it was from our Asian stories.And also some legend, some like the folk saying. So help us to understand why we have these four words or why we have three words or even longer words to express. And we call them idioms, 成语。那我们常常看到的成语都是四个字的。And我们有 more than 50,000 idioms we have in Chinese and 96% of them are four words. 四个字的常常都是成语。那也有一些是三个字的或者很长的 sentence. For example, 我给你们找了一个 example, 常常会用。只许州官放火不许百姓点灯。It looks like a sentence, but actually it's also a 成语。那这句话的意思是Only allow someone to do something, but like the other people or the normal people, they can do something. They cannot do the same thing. 那如果你们感兴趣 later you can check the sentence how we can use it in our real life. 只许州官放火，不许百姓点灯。Okay, 好，现在我们来一起看一看 the basic like the structures of idioms. Okay, so 我们可以看，我找了六种。Six kinds of the structures we will use in idioms a lot. So first one is kind of our sentence. We will have subject, we will have verb, and also we will have the object. So from the words we can know, 愚公 is a person. 移 is the action, to move. 山 the mountain. 你们猜一猜, you can guess. A people can move a mountain. 这是什么意思呢?要坚持, so you will keep doing, even you will meet a lot of difficulties or the obstacles, but never give up, keep doing, and you can move the mountain like 愚公 as well. 愚公移山, it comes from a legend story. No one knows if he really moved the mountain. 好好的，那第二个万象更新 is the same. So 万象 is a subject, 更 and 更新 is a verb and object. Okay, 我们看第二个。第二个 structures, we will have two parts. Yeah, the two parts. The first part we will have subject and also the verb, and then the second part is another subject and another verb. So for example, 第一个。手舞足蹈 So 手跳舞足 is our feet 蹈 it also means to dance So 我们想一个人他的手在跳舞他的脚也在跳舞 Wow So we describe someone extremely happy We will say 手舞足蹈 So happy And then you can see the people 跳舞跳得很开心 Okay, and the second one is 草长莺飞. "草长莺飞" is a quite written language, so we will use in the articles, we will use a lot. Okay, and the 三个 structures, we will have a verb and object, and then the second part, also a verb and object. So, 第一个有没有人听过知己、知彼？我们知己，知道你自己。知彼，彼 is another side. So 你也知道别人。这个是 it comes from an ancient literature. It means you know you, you know yourself very well, and also you know others very well. Then you can make the things. So you can do it. You can get the success. Okay.那还有第二个，画蛇添足。我们蛇是 snake， 蛇是 snake，蛇有没有足？没有 ，of course 它没有足。但是有的人呢，他觉得，我觉得这个蛇要画脚 ，so 添足 ，it means it's useless，没有用，画蛇添足没有用。OK， 好，所以 three structures here。We can, it's similar as a sentence, subject, verb, or object, and also subject, verb, or object. 好，我们再看看还有 Wow, I'm so glad you are all making notes, work so hard. Another three structures. We will say two long phrases together. So 第一个，粗心，大意。So 粗心，心 our heart, 意 our mind.But the adjective before is 粗 and 大，为什么呢 ？It's very, it's very careless.
为什么？
为什么？很好的问题。你看，你的心很大，你的 mind 很大。Then you will have a lot of things need to think. Then of course you will forget. Yeah. 所以你看，粗心大意。We can tell the meaning from the characters already. It's very careless.好 ，next one， 千山万水 ，like the thousand mountains and also thousand water， 千山万水。好 ，and the second structure， we will have two verbs phrase together。突飞猛进 ，in get improved， and 突和猛 is also the words to describe how you fly and also how you get improved。所以突飞猛进常常说一个人的 improvement or progress 很快很大。那所以我觉得你们的老师都希望你们的汉语突飞猛进。今天 HSK1 after the event HSK5 这个就是突飞猛进。所以你看是不是很快很大的 progress。那后面还有一个勇往直前 So 勇往直前我们说话的时候也常常用它的意思呢 To be brave 不要害怕勇敢的去做 So to be brave 勇往直前好的 And the lots of structures I want to share with you It's a very familiar structures as wellAnd you will do something, and also you did, 你做的怎么样 So verb, and then we can after that put different degree expressions. Okay, 这个爱不释手 it's a little bit hard. So I can tell you the meaning directly. It means, 你很喜欢这个东西，非常非常喜欢，你不可以放下 You cannot put it down because you like it so much.这个就是爱不释手。这一个你们来猜一猜，重于泰山。有人去过泰山吗？泰山 ，Yeah, Tai Mountain in 山东，在山东 ，Tai Mountain。在这里呢，它不是指 difficult， 不是指 hard， 这个只是指 responsibility or like your promise。你的 responsibility 和你的 promise， it's。As important or as deep as a mountain. So it's 是非常非常重要的 responsibility 和 promise. 所以是重于泰山。OK, 现在你们觉得成语难不难？很简单。So today we will share different kinds of the idioms, including the number, the animal, and also the part of our body, and also like different structures, idioms. So first, number. 我们从数字开始，先从一，一心一意。
Maybe it's wholeheartedly, like, I don't know how I can say this in English.
Yeah, so
wholeheartedly.
Yeah, wholeheartedly, and also 一个心，一个意。
一个意。
Yeah, so you have one heart and one mind. It means concentrate, concentrate. 看，现在我们都在一起学习汉语，没有做其他的事情，我们都在一心一意学成语，对吧？ Yeah, so very concentrate, 就是一心一意。OK, 那再看第二个呢？一心两用。It's obvious, 不是那么的 concentrate 了。你的一个心可以去做两件事情，可以去想两件事情，那常常就是指这个人不太认真，就是一心两用。还有三心二意，其实三心二意它的意思，你会想很多，你会想一想这个，想一想这个，想想这个，然后你去 You are not very firm in will, you will be hesitate.就是三心二意、啊、总是想太多了，你不可以很快的 make the decision, 就是三心二意。这个词啊，这个词 这个词我们说话的时候可以用，不三不四、
哦、也不是这个也不是那个
对对 almost 就像是一些爸爸妈妈他们看到一些孩子穿一些 very cool, like some very fashioned and also extraordinary clothes. It was 穿的不三不四，像什么样子 ？It's not very serious. So 不三不四说话的时候可以常常用。It also can mean, let me see the, I also checked the English meaning. Its literary meaning can be disrespectful and also like the nondescript. 像这样也不像那样、哦、这是什么？什么都不是，三不四。Then others 很简单，五颜六色。So it means colorful.
Colorful.
In Chinese, we know when we say some numbers, it doesn't mean the exact number. It means several or a lot of. So here, 五颜六色 five and six colors, it means a lot of colors. So it means colorful, 五颜六色。Okay.好，下面一个五湖四海。Five lakes, four ocean. 那现在我们可以说 the whole world, not only for China, also the whole world. 我们可以说五湖四海。So for example, 在 GoEast 有来自五湖四海的学生。在 GoEast 有来自五湖四海的学生。It means from all of the world.五湖四海。So, 如果你们想知道是哪五个湖，哪四个海，你们可以去看一看。It's five lakes in China and also four oceans in China. The next one, 七上八下。Now we say 七上八下 is kind of our heartbeat. 七上八下，七上八下。So, describe person that are very nervous, they are worried a lot.So, 你们想一想，当你们很紧张、很着急、很担心的时候，你的心跳是不是嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟嘟会很快？七上八下，对，七上八下。还有一个，十全十美 yeah, ，perfect， 完美，很好。So, 十全十美是完美 ，perfect 的意思。因为在汉语，十常常可以是 four。F-U-L-L, four. 所以呢你看已经 full of beauty is, of course, is perfect. 所以是完美，十全十美。好，所以我们可以说有没有人是十全十美的，有没有事情是十全十美的。It's kind of you want to describe something, if there anyone can be perfect or like the things can be perfect. 我们可以用十全十美。好。最后一个 the number 九死一生 the situation it must be very dangerous 对、嗯、很 危险, very dangerous. And we can say the situation is 九死一生. 就像Sara说的, 有九次 you will be dead and only one survival chance. So 九死一生, very dangerous. 所以你看,这些成语难不难? Yeah, I won. 但是这个汉字的 characters is not hard, right? 第一个我们刚刚知道了,画蛇添足. Why people draw a snake and add a foot? So it's useless. 那第二个呢？盲人摸象。盲人摸。盲人摸象。有没有人听过这个故事？ Hear the story before. 盲人摸象。你是一个盲人。 你去摸, you touch the elephant. 如果你摸它的鼻子, 你会觉得, 啊, 这个大象很长。 如果你摸它的body, 它的身体, 会觉得这个大象很大。 你摸它的tail, 你觉得这个大象很细。 但是, it's not the whole elephant, just a part of the elephant. So it means when people to think or to recognize or to make some like to make some idea, you cannot from only one or several aspects. You need to think of the whole. 所以这个就是盲摸象。鸟语花香，鸟 birds 语 bird singing, 花 flower 香. Yeah, so you see the bird singing and the flower moon. So it can describe a very beautiful word, especially in spring. 春天,鸟语,很漂亮。虎背熊腰。 So who wants to be 虎背熊腰? The back as broad as a tiger and the waist as thick as a bear. Who wants to be in that figure? 虎背熊腰常常是说一个人的 figure. 像老虎,像熊一样,非常的 strong,非常的大。 但其实而且这个是有一点点 negative。 你说一个人虎背熊腰,他会不开心。我很胖吗? 我虎背熊腰? 你说我虎背熊腰,我会生气。 所以虎背熊腰可以说一个人 very strong,a lot of muscle。 但是常常的也是有点胖,不太好。 像老虎一样,像熊一样,虎背熊腰。 So, 这是关于动物的, usually you can tell the meaning from the words, literary meaning as well. 好, let's see our very familiar part, our body. 第一个, 大手大脚, 又是我们的手和我们的脚, again. 对, 所以呢, 大手大脚常常是说, you spend the money, you spend the time without saving. If you have a very big hand, all the money just flow from your hand. Don't hold the money very tight. 所以呢, 花钱不要大手大脚。我的妈妈常常对我说, 你花钱不要这么大手大脚, please save some money. 对,所以是 without saving, 大手大脚。OK, 手舞足蹈, we just learned it. And we have three words all related to mouth and heart. 第一个, 口是心非, so 口, say yes, 但是你的心, say no. 所以这个意思就是指这个人他说的和他想的不一样。 这个就是口是心非。那一般这个也是 negative meaning. 那第二个,心口不一, but this one is also the negative meaning. And especially we will say someone is think different from what you say, the same, but it can describe people's high proxy. So it's a very bad meaning, high proxy. 他这个人, maybe it's not so good to make friends with this kind of people. 所以是心口不一。好,那第三个, 心直口快。 It's words can describe the personality. 心直口快，一个人说什么没有过大脑，没有继续想想个这一段话会不会伤人，或者这一段话好不好，想什么就说什么。对，常常就是说这样的一个人呢，他会有一个 straightforward temperament， 他想什么就说什么，不会好好的考虑，不会好好的想一想再说。 所以心直口快有时候是一件好的事情，有时候就像Sara说的，可能会do the harm to someone。心直口快可以是好的，也可以是不好的。OK，还有一个目中无人，目，我们的眼睛，你的眼睛里面没有人，that's also personality。 我们说看不起别人，对，所以目中无人，你的眼睛里看不到别人，那这个人其实是非常的 aggrant， 他不尊重别人的，是非常的 aggrant， 眼睛里都没有别人了。It means you won't take anyone into consideration. OK， 所以这个是目中无人，这些难不难？ And the last one, I want to ask you to guess. 15个人说话, which idioms can describe the situation? 15个人，很多人在说话，就是15个人说话，我们今天也只有12个人，没有15个人。15个人说话，它的意思就是，我来写给你们，七嘴八舌。
七嘴八舌，就像刚才Nermin说的，很多人在说话，而且这些人说话，他们的想法都不太一样，就是七嘴八舌。Sometimes
it can be massive, annoying. 大家不要七嘴八舌，听我说。 Just listen to me. 你们不要七嘴八舌，听我说。 OK, It's really 15 people there. It's just like a lot of people that are talking. 你就可以说七嘴八舌。OK, 所以你看，这是我们的身体。我们的身体可以告诉我们这个成语是什么意思。还有一些是这个, this kind of the structures. 有一些成语看起来不像成语。 So like 风风火火，偷偷摸摸。 日日夜夜，心心念念，迷迷糊糊。
I just know the last one, 迷迷糊糊, that's mean when you ask someone about like 你好吗，迷迷糊糊这样的，好，对不对？
我们不太会在 reply to the greeting, so 迷迷糊糊, it means you are confused, you are not very clear mind, 迷迷糊糊。
哦，就像这个,
so, so like this picture, so the person, 你看, 他好像不太清楚, have a lot of confusions, 就是迷迷糊糊。我估计你的意思是马马虎虎。啊，对, let me, 要说可能你想说的是马马虎虎, so just a so-so.
啊，对对对，这是我的意思。对，马马虎虎。马马虎虎。啊，就第一个,风风火火,
wind and fire. 现在 we will use 风风火火 to describe someone working or doing something very rushed, 很着急，像风一样，风很快，火 also very strong and quick. 所以我们说风风火火，一个人他做事情很着急. And also sometimes this can be like the reckless appearance. 偷偷摸摸 again. 偷偷摸摸的做一些事情，比如我的家有一只小猫 ，little kitty，晚上它不睡觉，偷偷摸摸的去吃东西，它不想让我知道，所以要偷偷摸摸的 ，like a thief，日日夜夜，几天几夜，就是很多天很多夜。 日日夜夜就是很长的时间，日日夜夜就是很长的时间，心心念念，我的心一直在念。So, 念, the literal meaning is to read something. 那你如果在心里面一直说说说说说说说啊，我终于买到了我心心念念的苹果手机。Yeah, I'm looking forward to the phone for very long time. Finally, I get it. 心心念念的手机。So, 心心念念的人，心心念念的 something, it means you look forward a lot. You desire for it. 心心念念。念就是 you read it a lot of times, repeat a lot. 我觉得可能你们需要去 memorize 有点难。I hope after today's idioms event workshop, you will know how can recognize 成语. Thank you for your time. 谢谢你们。
谢谢你
辛苦了。